After a rather lengthy break, the PCC Cup Series returns at Hungaroring, and the entry list for this race was quite large, with quite a few local drivers making their attempts for the race. 8 of the 12 qualifiers were local drivers or part-time drivers, and they were doing very well in qualifying, with all of them inside of the top 20 in practice and in qualifying. Let's go to the race. Pole day brought a huge surprise to Salvatore Torregrossa for Scuderia Italia in the number 43 Agip Tutino. Leads the field to the green flag in what I believe is the most ragged start that I have ever seen in the PCC Cup Series. Nicholas Cordova is there on the inside trying to make a move, entering turn one, trying to outbreak Torregrossa in the 43, and he does it. Cordova's will take the lead in the number 39 there, and Louis Ballard makes a look on the inside for second. Coming into turn two, he's on the outside now, and he gets the position as Torregrossa falls back to third place. Now in the back here, Claire Ossier wrecked on her qualifying lap, so she starts last, but she's already making mincemeat of the back markers as she gets around Worthington there, and she sets work on Hofacker and I believe that's Blackwater there in the 35, as she already passes two cars by the time the green flag's been thrown as she crosses the line there. And now she sets work on getting by Blackwater here, and she does so quite handily. She was very fast in all the practice sessions, and she is going to be flying through this field. Cordova still leads over Ballard, and Ballard making only his third start of the season. He nearly won Road Atlanta, and he won Las Vegas in that car, so it's expected to see him up front. Good to see him there instead of Kirkpatrick in that car. Kirkpatrick normally drives the 41 car for his own team, JK Racing, but Cordova's doing one hell of a job in that 39 car. We had quite a few part-time drivers qualify for this race. Here's two of them battling for 13th. We've got Lenore Scurry and Ben Atkins battling for that position. Scurry we saw earlier at Mansfield subbing for Gaspar D'Souza, but Ben Atkins, this is his debut, and he's running quite well in this number 5 Guinness STS. The Englishman doing quite well in his debut as he drifts his car there through the grass, trying to run down Scurry, who is doing much better than we saw her do at Mansfield. By lap 2, Claire Ossier is already up to 32nd place. She's trying to work around Sam Brown for that position, and she does so right there as Sam Brown gets into the marbles coming through that turn. And oh, he gets a bit sideways, and we've got a wreck back there, but Claire Ossier making mincemeat of the back of the field as she works on Craig Jasner now here in the 51, as he just kind of lets her by for 30th place there as Ossier works her way through the field. Let's go back and see what happened to Sam Brown here as he gets into the marbles, tries to get back on track. And, oh, he gets tagged by Barton Sandy. He goes hard into the wall there, and he gets stuck in the grass. Barton Sandy's got quite a bit of damage on that number 66 Holden. But Sam Brown gets stuck in the grass here on lap 2. Tough break for him. He's going to have to get towed back to the pits. Louis Ballard in the number 41. Welcome back, Louis Ballard. It's a nice change of pace from John Kirkpatrick in this car. Normally we'd see Kirkpatrick in the back, or Alex Tanker, who actually managed to make Kirkpatrick look good. But Louis Ballard, welcome back to the series. It's good to see you here again, and looks like you got back right where you left off, running up near the front. He is currently hounding Cordovos for the lead. And Barton Sandy comes out of the pits here. He had to take the hood off of that car, and he gets going again, albeit quite down in the running order. Here is Stanislav Warzowski running right behind Jan Schmidt, two of the other local drivers here, and they're running in 16th and 17th right now, and Warzowski is in the only Kosovet in the field. Three of them entered for this race, but Zygmunt Koufax in the 89 and Andros Baumgartner were not quite fast enough to make the show, but Warzowski, the local Polish rally champion, he is doing one heck of a job in this underpowered Kosovet, running in the top 20. Mikko Rantanen also is doing a heck of a job. He's running in the top 20 as well in this car for Frank Azzaretto's operation. This is the third driver they've had in that car, Azzaretto, Chuck Johnson, and now Rantanen in this car. And Rantanen is running quite well. He is running the best out of anybody who's qualified this car. And I wouldn't be surprised if he managed to finish up in the top 20 with this car, because he is driving the wheels off of that thing as you see him get a bit sideways there. Here we're going on board with Claire Ossier once again as she has worked her way up to 24th by lap 5. She's running right behind Giuseppe Balducci in that number 42 car, the other Tutino in the field, as she's having a bit of trouble getting up to speed here, trying to get around him, but that's because this is one of the more technical parts of the track, and Balducci happens to know this track a bit better than Aussier. This is the first time we've ever been to Hungaroring, but Aussier closing in rapidly on the leaders. Here's another local driver, Leonid Chernov, driving the number 16 for Rus Autosport, currently runs 4th on lap 6. He was the center of controversy during the qualifier because as he was going to lap Flint Stoneman, he punted him off the track, refusing to use the brakes. Tom Delgado Racing decided to reject their appeal for this incident because it seems that the officials here at the Hungaroring are stilted towards local drivers and will probably just throw the issue out. Here's Chris Winter running in 6th place on lap 7. He's doing one hell of a job driving this car up here. He's holding off Sergei Yakovsky back there in the number 61, team car to the 16, who you just saw in the foreground there, sponsored by Lukoil. But Chris Winter doing one heck of a job. He is driving the wheels off of this car. This car I would not consider to be a top-tier car in the series, although Dan Lecklater did put this car into victory lane at Carbondale, but he is a short track star. Chris Winter punching above his weight here today. Here's Lenora Scurry with some interesting signage on the side of that car. This is her own car that she brought to the track. We saw her earlier in the year where she kind of made a mockery of herself at Mansfield, but she's doing well here today. She's running in the top 20. I believe she's running in 17th right now, and hopefully we'll see more of her in this European Tour in her Maserati, the only Maserati in the field here today, and she will be joining us also at Brno and a couple other races later in the season. Sam Brown here about to go 2 laps down to Nicholas Cordovos, and he just kind of lets him by. Sam Brown's day has been the epitome of disaster here as he was taken out on the second lap. Nicholas Cordovos, however, has opened up a massive lead over Louis Ballard. Louis Ballard in the 41 is about 10 seconds back at this point. Scratch that, not 10 seconds, but more like 5, but he is currently driving away from Ballard, as Cordovos obviously has the most powerful car here today. Ben Atkins still in a heated battle with Lenore Scurry. On lap 8, he hits the bumps and something breaks on that car as he slows down and lets Jan Schmidt by there. And Claire Aussier and Stanislav Worzowski. Worzowski gets into him there in that turn, but Ben Atkins, something is wrong with that car as he pulls that car over to the side of the track and he is done for the day. It turns out a valve failure on that car will put him out of the race. Lap 11, Clara Kindall makes a move on the inside of Leonid Chernov for 4th place, and she will get the position in turn 1, outbreaking him there and getting on the inside. Clara Kindall, also known as, well, Clara Crashall, as she seems to crash out of everything she runs in, is currently doing much better than expected. We expected her to, well, be crashed out at this point, but she's proving us wrong, and she is currently gaining on Torregrossa for 3rd position. Here is Chris Winter, and he gets a bit into the sand trap there, trying to get around Ben Worthington, who is quite off the pace. He's about 10 seconds off the pace at this point, and he's just holding up the leaders. As you see there, he's trying to get off people's way, trying to let Sergei Yakovsky by, but Chris Winter keeps getting jammed up behind him, as there goes Greg Maddux around him again, and Chris Winter, understandably furious, he makes a move on the inside there and he'll get around him, but if you look here, you can just see how slow he is as he jams up three of the front runners there, Gaspar D'Souza, Dave Hetzel, and John Bracci, and D'Souza has to make some evasive maneuvers into the grass, and he goes 3 wide again, and he's just all over the place. Talk about being a moving chicane. And there's Sam Brown right behind him, who's not much better, but they're both holding up. All these cars back here for about 15th on back. As you see here, we've got the double wide moving chicane. Good luck getting past that. As, they're all over the track, as you see from this helicopter view. I think that they're getting by, but they're still holding up all the cars there, as somehow Worthington is making his car a double wide, and not sure why you'd want to do that, as Claire Aussier sneaks into the picture as she's moved herself into the top 20 there. And here is Nicholas Cordovos as he puts Preston Bell a lap down. He has started to side through the back of the pack, and in front of him is Jim Zahofacker, who we're seeing for the first time in the 23 car. He managed to bring some of his own funds to this 23 car to get them over here because, well, they wouldn't have been able to do so with John Jefferson. Their funding just wasn't there. But as he passes that car, it's devoid of sponsorship, but I'm not really sure where that money is coming from then, if that car is devoid of sponsorship. Here's Jacob Eichholz, and he's running in 21st place, and his car breaks down on him in turn two as Ben Worthington goes around him there. He pulls the car off to the side, and he's going to have to get that thing towed back to the pits. Tough break for Eichholz. He was having a decent run here today and starting to work his way through the field. Here's Clara Kindall making an interesting strategy call as she pulls into the pits on lap 15. This is a 40-lap race, and I'm not sure if she's going to be able to make it the rest of the way on fuel because, well, fuel pits are about 5 or 6 laps away at this point. And here we've got Greg Maddux, who's currently running in the top 5. He's getting ready to put Lenny Jacobs a lap down. Chris Winter right behind him is in 6th place. And Greg Maddux is currently slated to run in the WSCC, the World Sports Car Championship, which will make its first appearance at Miashkova Airport, and that's going to be interesting to see. But Greg Maddux is currently outpacing his teammate, Cameron Taylor. He is currently running in 5th place, and this is the second Winslet Motorsports car, so kind of surprised to see him running as well as he is. Here is Leonid Chernov, and oh, he just ran into the back of Salvatore Torregrossa there. And I believe he's reporting brake issues at this point. Not sure if that's holding over from the qualifier or not, where he ran into Flint Stoneman right there. But brake wear is at an all-time high at this track, and quite a few teams have been reporting brake issues with their cars. And here is Clara Kindall, who has moved up into the top 15 at this point. She's currently making a run for 12th, using Jimsa Hofacker as a pick there in turn 2. And she will take the spot using Hofacker as a pick. And D'Souza tries to make it 3 wide, and the handling is going away on her car a bit as she slides through the grass there, but keeps it on track, and she'll continue to move up through the pack. Jan Schmidt running in 18th place. He blows up on lap 18. Unfortunate for him. He was looking to have a good run here today, but I guess the engine just couldn't hold out much longer. We're going to see this car a few more times in the season. They're going to be at Brno, they're going to be at Karjala, and they're going to be at a couple other tracks, so it's going to be interesting to see what they do. The Altoris GP car, they're also running in the World Sports Car Championship with Christopher Loxonen. There's a name we haven't heard in a while. He ran in PCC Cup Series last year. Leonid Chernov hits the pits on lap 19, and he's currently running up there near the front. And here's the back bumper of Nicholas Cordovos as he puts Craig Yoncer a lap down. And you can see how close that Louis Ballard's gotten. Ballard has really picked up the pace here the last few laps, and he is making a run at Cordovos once he gets around Craig Yoncer here, which he does quite easily. I think Yoncer just decides to let him by and doesn't want to hold him up. But Louis Ballard currently catching Nicholas Cordovos lap by lap here. Here's Ian Elias running in 22nd, and oh, he decides to run into the back of Barton Sandy for some reason. I believe he is also reporting brake issues, so it's going to be interesting to see if teams decide to replace the brake pads on their cars or not during the pit stops. That will take a little bit longer than others. Either that or clean the brake dust out of there, because clearly something's not helping these cars as they continue to drive around the track and use their brakes. David Hetzel comes in on lap 21 from 10th place. He's having a pretty strong run here today. David Hetzel, we haven't seen much of him as he's been DNQing for quite a few races. And the next lap, here comes Salvatore Torregrossa into the pits from 3rd place, and he is going to come in and make a stop. He is the strongest running one-off car. Not too surprising here, as that team actually has a bit of experience under their belt. They were at the Cleveland Grand Prix last year, and the next lap, Nicholas Cordovos comes into the pits. So as the leaders cycle out, Cordovos comes into the pits, and he is making the long trek down pit road. I believe that another car did come in from the leaders. Yes, there is Torregrossa coming out of the pits, I think. So as he dives into the pits there, we see Louis Ballard also into the pits. So they decide to pit at the same time, and Cordovas gets a big jump on Ballard out of the pits, and I think that Ballard actually lost quite a bit of time to Cordovas in the pits this time around, so that'll be interesting to see. And oh, Michael Grant decides to run into the back of Ike Durbin. I think the brakes went on that car, and he's just kind of floundered there on pit road. He can't get that car refired. And here we go on board Craig Yoncer, as he's reporting brake issues too. He tries to slide into the pits, and there is Very juvenile, so he goes out of the race, well, right after that. So he's kind of farting around there in the garage trying to get that car refired and back out onto the track, but it's not going to work out. Here's Lenora Scurry, who decided to roll the dice and go an extra lap trying to lead a lap. She only made it up to second place, so she pits the lap afterwards. An interesting gamble here by the 69 team, but ultimately it didn't work out for them. They ended up only in second place, so she will end up a bit further down in the running order, but it was an interesting gamble and a calculated risk that I think should have been taken. Here is Salvatore Torregrossa, and he managed to get out in front of Louis Ballard, so Ballard falls back to third now, and Torregrossa looks to be the main contender for the win over Corradovos, but Corradovos is way out in front, and I have no idea if the Tutino is strong enough to catch the Katsev. Here's somebody having a good run. Stanislav Worzowski is running right behind Mikko Rantanen in the 64. He is currently in 17th place, doing a good job in this Kosovet. I did not think that this car was going to be anywhere near the front, but he's managed to hang up there in the top 20 and show that this car really is not that bad after all. The former Polish rally champion, he won the title back in 2008, and since then he's been doing a bit of rallycross throughout this part of the country. I believe that he does have some experience at this track, so that's helping him out here. As, whoa, Chris Winter gets a bit sideways, and he continues to struggle to deal with lap traffic as Cameron Taylor gets by him now. As Cameron Taylor and Barry Juveno go at it for that. But Juveno is currently a lap down, and Winter is trying to work his way around Juveno, but he continues to struggle with lap traffic as Juveno chops him off there. Winter has fallen back a little bit, but he's still running in the top 10 as he desperately tries to work around Juveno there. And here is Clara Kindall as, oh, Cody D comes across her, and they both spin out there in that turn. Clara Kindall, tough break for her. She was running in about 12th place. She had fallen back a bit. She had a bad pit stop, but Cody Deke got way out of line there. As you see, he tries to save the car, and he just turns right into Kindall, and then Jacob Eichholz runs into him, and they both go spinning off the track, so Eichholz's day can't get any worse from here on out. But Deke is a lap down, and he's just trying to soldier home and try and get a decent finish, but he did not need this to happen to him today here. And here is Giuseppe Balducci, who's having a decent run. He doesn't have much experience in stock cars, and it shows, but he's currently just riding along. He's in 20th place, a respectable showing for the second Tutino. They just kind of brought him on as a sort of gentleman driver for this car. He's partially funding his own 42 team, and I believe he has a minority ownership in that team, so he's fulfilling a dream that he's had of actually driving in the PCC Cup Series here. And here is Claire Ossier, whose handling is starting to go away on that car, as I mentioned before. Even with the new tires on that car, her car is not handling right, as, oh, she makes a little mistake there, hits the marbles, and she goes off. So Claire Ossier's excellent run has kind of stalled out around about 10th or 11th place. She's trying to get by a couple cars that are in front of her, as John Bracci up there, that is for position, but she lost quite a bit of ground. Here is Claire Kindall, who has recovered a bit. She's running with Dave Hetzel right now in the top 15 as she drives off in that turn as well. But Clara Crashall, as the nickname returns, as she wrecked yet again here. So I don't think there's been a race this season where she hasn't wrecked out. Lenore Scurry running with Gaspar de Sousa, the driver who she replaced at Mansfield when he was injured. So Lenore Scurry, as I mentioned before, she has some interesting signage on that car. I'm not sure why the officials allowed that to run on the track, but I'm not exactly an official, so I don't have anything to say about that. As Corradovos goes off when he's trying to lap Gavin DeGray. So I think that the second set of tires hasn't exactly warmed up to the track yet, as Corradovos makes a rare mistake trying to put Gavin DeGray, who's running in 24th, last car in the lead lap, a lap down. Corradovos still has quite a bit of breathing room, though, so I don't think he should be driving too hard to try to get around DeGray, but I'm not driving that car, so I don't really have anything to say. As D'Souza, oh, he gets into Sam Brown, and he goes into the inside wall hard. That's going to do quite a bit of damage to that right front quarter panel, as we're going to get a good view of it here. As you see, right there, it's all crumpled up, so tough break for him as he's going to soldier on. I don't think they're going to bring that car into the pits. As we go on board Louis Ballard, and we see that he's caught Salvatore Torregrossa in that 43 car as Louis Ballard is making one heck of a drive out of this. He's trying to get up to second place as Corradovo's is long gone. This is basically turned into a battle for second. So let's see what Louis Ballard has for Salvatore Torregrossa here in the closing laps. Clara Kindall in the closing stages of the race has moved up to 10th position. She got around John Bracci, but now she's stuck behind Barton Sandy and Chester Benson there. She's trying to get around Lewis Jones for the 9th position, but her handling has been slowly going downhill. There's something wrong with that car she goes a bit wide in turn 2 and she drives through the grass, and that's going to let John Bracci get a run on the outside there along with Clara Kindall. Kindall gets stuck behind Barton Sandy, but I don't know if she's going to be able to keep up. By this shot, I think she's gotten around. Chester Benson cuts across, and Clara Kindall goes out of the race with just 2 laps to go. Ah, a tough break for Clara Kindall as she crashes out yet again from a very good performance here. On the final lap, coming to the checkered flag, Salvatore Torregrossa is trying to get around the left car of Kelly Blackwater, but Louis Ballard makes a look on the inside. Ballard is challenging for second place. It's going to be a photo finish for second place. Ballard has the advantage, but I think it's going to be Torregrossa getting the position. Torregrossa will get second place as we show you a view from the helicopter camera as Torregrossa manages to beat him in straight line speed as he takes second place. But nothing will stop Nicholas Corradovo as he drives that car to a dominating victory, leading every single lap here at the Hungaroring. However, on the cooldown lap, his car slows here, and he will stop on the track as his car apparently breaks down on the cooldown lap. So either Corradovo's is extremely lucky, or the second and third place cars who just passed him right there just barely ran out of luck. Leonid Chernov hung on to finish in fourth place. And Greg Maddox and Cameron Taylor, good job for Winslot Motorsports here today. They managed to finish 5th and 6th, and Chris Winter hangs on to finish 7th despite fighting with some lapped cars over some real estate for some reason. I'm not sure why the lapped cars just didn't get out of his way. Maybe they thought they were actually battling him for position. Sergei Yakovsky, Leonid Chernov's teammate, finishes 8th. Lewis Jones leads the Australian Motorsports Brigade with a 9th place, and Claire Osier, round of applause for her. She worked her way from last place all the way into a top 10 position.